kicking your can all over the place, singing,
we will, we will rock you.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the best of the British. We thank you for choosing to fly with Dandenong High School Performing Arts Airways. We shall be commencing quite shortly, so we ask that you please ensure your mobile phone is switched off for the duration of the flight. We invite you now to sit back and let us entertain you.
Don't pay close attention to the accent. You won't be doing it right. You won't be getting the call. Take a few minutes, organize yourselves, go for it.
You're busy, Harry. You know my methods, Watson.
Bond? James Bond?
Please, sir, can I have some more?
No! What did I just tell you? I said it's the best of British, not the best of international ridiculousness. Can someone please restore my faith in the future of the arts and do something right? Talking about, ladies and gentlemen. Now, I finally found someone who can do the accent right, and we can get on with the rest of the show. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, small children and slightly taller children, my name is Ethan Colquhoun and I will be your host for this evening. With me tonight are my minions. We have Yusha, William, Nishadi, Vimasha, and Vishna, and we're here tonight to dazzle, to entertain, make you laugh, cry, and snort into your popcorn. Most importantly, we're here tonight to prepare you, our wonderful audience, for the mayhem you'll be seeing. And with that, I'd like to introduce to the stage the first act of this evening. My amazing... Our amazing, incredibly talented, spectacular actors with their performance of Blind Date!
Welcome to this week's installment of Britain's number one dating show, Blind Date, with Scylla Black. And now, please put your hands together for the wonderful, the charming, the one and only Scylla Black!
Welcome to Blind Date. This show brings people together, and here are three chaps looking to find the right girl because apparently they want everyone here to know that they can't find love for themselves. Anyway, let's welcome them in by giving them a big round of applause.
Tracy, maybe chop the song between the lumbada and the tango. But if I had to choose, I'll choose a tiger, so I can hold you real close.
Ooh! Oh my, that sounds wonderful. How about you, number two? What kind of dance would you do with me?
Well, Tracy, I'm a bit of a romantic, so I'll have to say the waltz, so I can hold you nice and close and waltz you away to the sunset.
Aww! That sounds so lovely. How about you, number three? What kind of dance would you do with me?
I don't dance.
Come on, we want to see you dance.
Number three! Number three! Number three!
For this special course in elementary dating. May I say how pleased I am with today's turnout? My name is Dr. Dylan Pillingsbotham Scott, and my co-lecturer for tonight will be Professor Pujana Benkinson-Jones.
Yes, thank you, Dr. Dylan. Tonight, we look at the first date. Obviously, taking out a girl for the first time is a very complex issue. To help guide us through this process, we have our wonderful volunteer, Mr. Bean. Now, the first crucial step is having arranged to pick up your date and not look like a complete idiot when she opens the door. Best to look as though your attention has been momentarily distracted.
But when you do notice her, it is vital to show how pretty she is looking straight away.
But don't overdo it.
If at this point you are introduced to her parents, attitude is all important. You can be too keen.
Or you can be too casual.
Dad?
And when you say goodbye to the parents, again, do not overdo it.
I don't want to leave you!
Now is the time to get going. Lead her to your vehicle and remember to open the door.
Once in the car, there are various ways of driving. If you drive like this,
loser,
you might lose her respect.
But if you drive like this, you really should have taken a taxi.
Get out of the car.
And escort her to the table. And remember to tuck into her chair yourself.
And attract the waiter's attention.
Now, selecting from the wine list is very important. Complete ignorance is not good at all.
When the bottle arrives, there is much to be done in the tasting of it, but don't be too professional and too much of a show-off.
Now, with eating, moderation is the order of the day. You can eat too fast.
But don't eat too slowly either.
Now next is how to behave when receiving the bill.
This is a very important moment and you must be sure not to lose your cool. This is right.
This is totally wrong.
The girl, of course, may often pay herself, in which case, you should refuse. I said refuse.
Now, the next stop for you and your date is the fashionable dance club. Now, once inside the dance club, you might look slightly strange trying to talk over the loud music. So just stand casually and try to look sexy.
This is good.
This is better.
This is starting to get misguided. Seriously, stop that. Just stand up straight.
After stance, dance technique is most important. Most people don't know how to dance, so they just do too much.
Other people do way too little.
And some people just shouldn't dance at all. When all is said and done, it's probably best not to dance at all. The well-marked sporting injury is a good way to get out of dancing.
If you don't utterly muck it up, 20 minutes later, you should be back at your place.
It is important to relax. Make your guest feel at home. She will be as nervous as you. So there's really no need to make any extra special effort.
When putting on the music, we can't help with the choice of CD. However, please be aware that no matter what the circumstances,
Nicki Minaj or Snoop Dogg
would be a mistake.
At all costs, avoid the temptation to brag about your place.
Now comes the moment you've been waiting for.
The seduction. However, we have run out of time and this will be the topic of our next week's lecture.
We said we're out of time.
I lose my number. You never gave it to me.
Loser.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, please. Oh, I didn't see you there. Oh, don't help me.
40 years. That's right, 40 years. Everyone, please put your hands together and welcome Mr. Albino.
Thank you. did say sorry about the old man part. Just from the
heart, I object to your... You automatically treat me like an inferior.
I am king.
Oh, king gave very nice. And how to get that? By exploiting the workers? By hanging out to an outdated imperialist dogma, which perpetuates the social and economic differences between the classes? Is this ever going to be a protest?
Yeah. Over here!
Guys.
Well, no, Hans, but they didn't get to design our uniforms. Their uniforms, they're quite nice.
obviously the last thing that we've learned in the last 1,000 miles of the retreat is that Russian agriculture is in dire need of mechanization, but you've got to say, it is a lot better than a skull. I mean, I cannot think of anything better than a skull.
What about a rat's buttocks?
I would be a lot less worried if we were marching under a flag of a rat's buttocks.
Listen,
Don't tell me you're looking down this bit. You're supposed to look down this bit here.
What? I thought you did this bit.
No, if you look down that bit, you won't hit anything.
All right, we'll give it to her. God, this is him.
I don't have any left.
Down this bit. I can do it. For one year. Gitanka. First it's in. Fire.
Thank you. vice versa, friends. Thought I'd let you know, we found a replacement for Miss McCarthy. His name is Mr. Logan. Now, as friends, thought it would be right to tell you that he's a bit weird.
I was chatting with him this morning and he was telling me about Elizabeth in England, but not in past tense.
I know, right? We were talking about the dinosaur senior archaeology unit. Like, dinosaurs are not bad as people. Yes, now, that is what I meant. He's taking over senior English, so as science teachers, we don't have to deal with him too much, but I thought I'd let you know, just in case you happen to interact with him. Sorry?
Oh, I'll just say, you look like someone from the movie.
Who?
I forgot the name, but wasn't it from that British one?
Oh yeah, the one with the Curtis.
The space shuttle one, yeah?
Yeah.
Oh, rubbish, it looks nothing like him. Alright, we don't have time, we need to get ready for class, alright? Time for new school life!
Tell the nurse, so then I had to get my diary signed, and that's why I'm late.
I smell bull. I'm having none of it. No. You people don't be out of steam to value time. You might not respect your own, but you sure as hell respect mine.
That's right, Mr. King, you got it.
Shut up. Now let me show you about the car. Now I know when you look at me, you see this delicious bear of sexiness. But let me tell you, this took work. And this took time. This is not easy. You know what 10 minutes means to me? 10 minutes is me, and I'm running on the treadmill. And I'm looking in the mirror. Are you in yet? No, you're not. Listen, 10 minutes is 110 calories, okay? What's 110 calories? That's a third of a Snicker bar, okay? Whatever. A fifth of my lunch and a tenth of my dinner. Okay, that's what 10 minutes means to me. And if I have the same attitude as you when it comes to time, that's the difference between me looking like Michael B. Jordan and you being able to pour those honey and dial those chicken numbers on your AM. As opposed to going to the direction of Homer Simpson.
Gary's mummy dropped off his lunch. You left the lunch in the kitchen from when you ran out the house late.
street strings now, would you?
No.
Alright. Get ready for English. Heard your new teacher's always on time.
Cheese strings, you loser!
Get out of the back, cheese!
Get out of my seat!
Can't believe we've got double English.
Yeah, English is well dry.
I see what's so good about reading anyways.
Nah,
reading's for losers!
In it though? Mm. At least we've got a new English teacher.
Mm. Yeah, that'll be a laugh, won't it?
Now let's all turn to page 53 in our poetry textbooks. I think we'll dive straight in with the bard himself.
Sir?
Yeah?
Are you English, sir?
No, I'm Scottish.
So you ain't English then?
No, I'm British.
So you ain't English then?
No, I'm not, but as you can see, I do speak English.
But I can't understand what you're saying, sir.
Well, clearly you can.
Right, were you speaking Scottish now?
No, I'm talking English.
Don't sound like it.
Right. Whatever you want. Now, let's go on with Shakespeare.
I don't think you're qualified to teach English, sir.
I am perfectly qualified to teach you English.
I don't think you are, though.
Okay, let's go on with Shakespeare.
Sir, can I ask you a question?
Shakespeare's sonnets.
Sir.
Sonnets are
sir.
Long, written in 14
sir.
Lines.
Sir.
The last two
sir.
My fault.
Sir.
I write a couple of words.
Sir. Can I ask you a question?
Not just now.
Can I ask you a question now?
Just wait.
But I only want to ask you a question. Why can't I ask you a question? It's just a simple old question. Why can't I ask you a question? It's just a simple old question. Can I ask you a question? Can I ask you a question?
What is it?
So the question I want to ask you is, are you the doctor?
Doctor who? I still like Bubba!
Oh. Fatal beatings.
Thank you. Stop your swabbling. I need quiet to think.
Look!
Feelings. express their feelings, my friend.
I'm not deaf, little one.
Yes, my friend.
You know not everything I say requires a response, lesser one.
Yes.
Can I just quite say, I think she has quite a charming personality.
You can talk! Silence! I knew I should have made all you blue specimens mute.
That's it. That's all I can take. Why are these glorified toasters so terrifying of me? And why are people like them, who are not even real, and people like you, who have been dead over 100 years ago?
Oh. Exactly real yourself.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Well, that's because we have a very sophisticated cloning facility that uses DNA samples to clone human beings and fictional characters from the past. That's right! You're all clones! You mentioned the past. How long ago? What year is this?
Oh, I grow weary of your questions. Let someone answer them.
Oh, she wants her to speak now.
Once brilliant. You invented everything you needed and then some. The problem is you kept inventing and inventing and inventing till you could no longer manage your immense population. Not to mention what you did to this planet. Of course, one of your better inventions was a supercomputer connected to the World Wide Web. This computer kept learning, growing, and evolving into what eventually became our queen. She went on to create all of us. We are eternally grateful.
Why are they a bit lacking, a bit slow, a bit dumb in the head?
Do you not want us to be too emotional, too complicated, too ambitious, too greedy? She do not want us to be like you.
She seems pretty damn angry to me.
Yes. Although she can technically not feel, this connection certainly has affected her intelligence. And sometimes that can make her a little unstable, which makes her all the wiser to rule us. With the flip of her metallic mind, she can lead us in the right direction and guide us when we lose our way.
You mean violently shock me with electricity?
Something like that.
Oh my days, I've never heard of such a travesty as this. This is evolution gone wrong. For countless days, months, years, I strive to prove a simple theory. That only the fittest organisms adapt in order to survive. They live long enough to reproduce to continue the cycle. This is not survival of the fittest. This is an abomination.
Yes, I know who you are and what you strive to achieve over the countless days, weeks, months, even years. And you, Sir Robert Charles Darwin, are absolutely correct. For it is the survival of the fittest, and humans are not fit to rule the earth.
Excuse me, Miss Twisted Electronic,
whatever you are. What about us kids? We didn't do nothing wrong. It wasn't our fault.
Yeah, we didn't do anything.
Yeah, we don't even know what you're talking about.
Don't worry, sweetie. I have no clue what they're talking about either.
Yeah.
Oh, any college next door, the best of our Aussies.
Curious, how did you get from your enclosure into ours?
Well, I found a tiny weak spot to your electric system. They're a keen old spot like myself. Been sneaking around the joint ever since. I haven't told the other Aussies about it. We're all a bunch of Aussies running around, especially if there's beer. Oh, mate, don't I wish. Seriously though, the toaster will be on toast real quick. I don't like the look of that queen toaster. Screw it, she's only here a month feel like that hangover. Don't like the look of the guys in the world in the dark hour of that night, that's for sure.
Well, what are we waiting for? That's our way out of here. I knew there had to be a weakness in this structure. You see, nothing is as perfect as it seems.
Like I said, what are you trying to do if we're out here making friends with the toasters? The likely is that seems to be bleeding if they catch us escaping.
Interesting choice of words. The android sounds half bad. And from what we've seen, they are the majority. If we somehow befriend them and convince us to let us go, then we can make our way back to Merry England and live our lives in peace. Fictional and not fictional alike.
Nah, man, you're dreaming. The Queen's got some kind of mental control over them. Good luck breaking that.
Guys, if you only had it once, we can cast a spell to break the bond between the Queen and the rest of the androids.
We don't. So what's the point of bringing up this? I can solve everything. We do!
Wait, by what do you mean those hocus-pocus things that wizards use in fairy tales?
Our action, Mr. Dundee. The three of us are all wizards, and I can assure you nothing hocus-pocus or make-believe about it.
Shh! It's true. Oh. One day I'm going to be a wizard.
And I'm going to be a witch when I grow up. And I found love. What? I don't even know who the hell you are! Besides your age, what are you? Eight?
Well, if you ask me, it's all proper rubbish. I'll believe when I see it. But I have stuck in a corridor once or twice before. Just happens to be three wands on display. With the title Wands of Harry Potter, something like that, mate.
Why didn't you tell us before?
Boy, who are you? Rightio, rightio, don't get nippers in knots. Never heard of you before. More importantly, what you're saying is true, and I can get us out of here. If you do your hocus pocus thing to break the bond between the Queen and the rest of them, we'll be sweet. Rightio, rightio, ready to do this? Too bad, my mouth's watering for a cold beef and a spot of fishing on the shores of Kakadu Lake.
Yeah!
Quiet! Gotta do this real quiet! Alright, I'm gonna toss it beyond us and we'll get caught and zapped into oblivion. Let me find this little fence thing. Boy, I gotta do this real quiet, alright? Ground here somewhere. Oh, I've got it. It's a bit tricky this time, but bingo, here she is. Come on, don't have all day.
Questions.
a ship, just like the Titanic!
I'll kill the world!
Shut up!
At least we know of the ship. Groovy, baby. All you know is the boat and sailing home with the boat.
Tom, what ocean is this? The Pacific? Atlantic? Tom, what is the nearest continent to this ship?
Next.
I beg your pardon. Again, Android, tell us where the nearest land is to this location.
Negative.
What is this nonsense you're muttering? I demand you tap into your computer mainframe and tell us where the nearest land is.
Tapping into computer mainframe now. The answer is negative.
Well, you tell your computer mainframe to check every coordinate on this planet. We must be near something.
Computer mainframe confirms that there is negative landmass on planet Earth.
Daddy, does this mean the whole world is one big ocean?
No, darling, don't be silly. Even I know that can't be true.
If only you had cherished the land beneath your feet.
That's what the Queen Android said earlier. Now we know what she meant.
No wonder she despises us so much.
Well, it doesn't take a genius to realize that only a few degrees hot will change the world forever. If it gets any hotter, the polar ice caps will melt and flood the Earth until the world is just one big ocean. Though for all due to natural causes, it would be tragic, but understandable. Android, tell me, was this disaster due to natural causes?
Computer mainframe says negative to global warming caused by natural causes.
Unforgivable, I say. What kind of legacy have we left? So much for survival of the fittest. This is a sad, sad day for humanity indeed.
Don't cry, my angel. But Mummy, all those people, everywhere. What happened to them?
Maybe in time the earth will heal and cool, and they'll be learned beneath our feet. Oh, how I would love to feel the head beneath my feet.
Your emotions have made you delusional. I created you. I would know what's best for you, and it's not living aside with these things.
You know, I feel that you are no longer fit to rule us.
You and what army?
Ability to step into somebody else's shoes. Brother, you with me?
Yeah, we got this, right? It's good.
No! No, you don't know what you're doing! You're making a huge mistake! I mean, you see the letter on the A! It never explodes!
We have doctors and specimens, so be quiet.
We have some celebrating to do.
Before you celebrate, swear to us that you will treat this land with the respect it deserves. Water, land, whatever it may be.
We swear!
And also, we have a gift for you.
What is it? I could do with a nice Guinness about now.
You will like the gift.
Manuel! You're alive!
When someone accidentally pushed you through an electric fence,
Mr. Forty, it's so nice to see you. I thought I was a fried shish kebab back then.
This is just for you, this present.
Is there any chance you could clone a non-nagging Kim Kardashian?
David!
I was just joking.
I have a gift for you too, dear Android. From this day forth, we are all the best of British.
Even me, mate?
Yes, even you, my fine leather Australian from down under. Even you. If it doesn't call for a celebration, I don't know what is. Maestro!
Thank you.
marriage of Daniel and Kate, to pray for God's blessing on them, to share their joy and celebrate their love. Marriage is a way of life. Marriage is a sign of unity. No one should enter into it lightly, but reverently and responsibly. It enriches society and strengthens community. It builds unity and is blessed among all. Daniel and Kate are now to enter this joyous way of life, make solemn vows, and will give each other consent. And in token of this, each will give and receive a ring. We pray with them for the strength and the wisdom to guide them on this journey. I'm now required to ask for anyone present for any reason that these two may shall not be lawfully married. Speak now or forever hold.
Italy, with two of his most beloved characters, Romeo assist me by betraying all the major characters in Romeo and Juliet while I fill in the bits of crucial narration. We begin with the prologue.
Two households, both alike in dignity, in fair Verona where we lay our scene. From ancient grudge breaks a new mutiny, where civil blood makes civil hands unclean. From forth the fatal loins of these two foes, a pair of star-crossed lovers take their life, whose misadventures, hideous overthrows, do with their death bury their parents' strife.
Easy, that's the way you're going. So don't make it easy. Lursome name was Tim. There, boss, and let me die. talk of these sad things. Some shall be pardoned, and some punished. For never was there a story of more woe than that of Juliet and her Romeo. Romeo and Juliet are dead.
So dead!
Dead! Romeo and Juliet are dead.
So dead!
Romeo is really dead, and Juliet is really dead. Romeo and Juliet are
dead.
Thank you.
Hello everyone, we are the Dandenong High School band, so I hope you guys enjoy the songs we're about to play for you.
Rocking.